How to do web development. In the previous tutorial, we covered basic HTML of how to put together an HTML page. We learned how to do tags, opening and closing tags. We learned kind of what some of those popular tag names are. And honestly, there's only 10 or 15 you actually need to know anyway. So hopefully by now you've taken that course and you're comfortable with kind of writing out basic HTML tags. This should look decently familiar to you. If not, go back through the last video and get comfortable. I promise it won't take very long. There's only a few tags you have to learn. And it really feels weird at first if you're not used to writing anything that feels like code, but I promise it comes very quickly. You won't be confused for long. So what I've done here is I've taken and modified my example from the last video. And now I have my HTML with a header and a body. And in that body, I have a header one, which says my website. I've got an unordered list with a link to three different pages. And I've got also a little bit of fake content. You'll notice this tag up here. I left this out in the last example because it didn't really apply to learning basic HTML tags. But we're going to add this at the top of every HTML page. And this just declares that the document type is HTML. And putting it like this actually means HTML5. So all you need to know is that it needs to be there at this point. It basically tells your browser, hey, we're working with an HTML5 page. What I did then is I created a new page called page2.html, and I saved it in the same folder. Then I created another page called page3.html. It's also in the same folder. And you can see here, I didn't include a full http://www.mywebsite.com. All I did is put it's called a relative link. If you don't put that full thing, it looks starting in the same folder that you're in now. And the reason we called our first page index is because index is what it's automatically going to look at when you load a website. If you go to google.com, you know, there can be some configuration changed to make it different, but by default, a website is going to look for index.html. So one thing I changed here is the first li, if it's on the page that you're on now, there's not going to be an a tag. It's because if we're on home, we don't have to go to home, we're already there. So as you can see on home, this is not a link. Page 2 and 3 are a link, and I can go to page 2, and it loads up page 2, and now home and page 3 are a link, because home is going to index, and 3 is going to page 3. So I can now navigate between all three pages of my website. See, it's not too bad. I basically have a website that's up and running. It's just ugly because there's no style. So let's get into how to add style to your web page. I've saved a file called main.css. And a CSS style sheet is how we do styling. And it basically works like this, is you have a selector, which is where we pick something we're going to add style to, and then you have a rule. The selector basically has brackets. Anything within those brackets gets applied to the selector. So the rule, you have the property that you want to change, and then the value you want to give it. And then you've got a colon, and it ends with a semicolon. This will probably be the weirdest part about CSS, is getting comfortable going selector, open some brackets, property, colon, value, semicolon. Probably looks weird, feels like it's a lot to memorize. It's going to come really fast. Type your selector, open some brackets, pick a property, pick a value for it, you're done. So in this case, we've picked body, so anything within the body is now going to get a background of 999. We'll get into this a little bit later, but for now, that just means a background of gray. Tell you what, we'll make it black. We'll make it red for now. That's a little easier to understand. So the body now gets a background of red. You notice when I refresh, nothing happens because this style sheet is not attached at all to my page. So there's two ways you can get style to your page. You can start by just going style and add a style tag. And we'll make sure we add this attribute, type equals text slash CSS, because we're doing CSS style. And now I can go body, background, nope, not bottom, red. Hit save. Hey, check it out. There you go. So you're thinking, why would I not clearly do it this way? This is much easier. But what if we want to type in 150 different rules and we want them to be shared between all our pages? Well, now you either have to copy paste or you put them in a separate file, which is what we're going to do here. We put background red in here, and now we can link to it. We're going to do a link, and this href is going to be, I'm going to link to styles main.css, and I need to do rel equals style sheet. And basically what that tells it is, I'm giving you a link to a style sheet. And we can also add type equals text slash CSS. Most new browsers don't need that, but some old browsers are going to. So now what we've done is we've added this link, and now all I have to do is add this link to each page, and each page is now going to get all the styles that I put in main.css. So now you see as I navigate, every page background is hideous red. I'm going to change that to a slightly more pleasant color, 999, which is kind of a grayish color. And so now we can add some more styles. Let's say we want to make our headers a better font. Actually, let's make the whole body a different font. Font family. Arial. There we go. That's a little bit cleaner looking. Now the font family is Arial. Now CSS is where you get into a decent bit more memorization. There's only about 10 or 15 HTML tags you use. There's a lot of CSS properties that you can adjust, because as you can imagine, every ounce of style that the whole page has is coming from these CSS properties. So it's just going to take you a little while. You'll want to start off with some things that are more comfortable and work your way up. It's not an endless black box. There's an end to it. It probably will only take you a few weeks, and then all of a sudden you realize, wow, there are no more CSS properties that I don't know. It's just a long few weeks of learning. So definitely give yourselves a little bit of time, have patience, and it will come very quickly. But at first you're gonna feel like you're just completely drowning in the ability to not do anything that you want it to do. We're going to show you a little bit more about selectors here real quick. So here's I've shown you how to grab things by tag name. That's what we did here. We just created a tag name, body. Usually you don't do that too often. You'll do it for body. You'll do it for H1. So I'll go H1. I'm going to go color. And this will be like a 333 color. And now you notice my H1 got just a little bit lighter. Let's change that a little bit more to 666. All the Mark of the Beast jokes. Yep, coming out. Basically, if you go all the way to 000, you're at black. If you go all the way up to 999, you're at a gray. And anything in between is kind of, well, in between. So I'm going to make that 555. But I also want this to apply to any H2s. So I'm going to do H1, H2. And now you'll notice my H2 also has a gray color. I could also make this P. I want any of my paragraphs to have this. I can make this any LIs. I want my LIs to have this. I can make this any A's. I want my A's to have this. And now I've styled everything with a color of 555. I don't want my A's to do that though, so maybe I'll make my A's a different color later on. Let's make my A's a little different color. Blue. There you go. Green. Everything's green. There we go. Everything's blue. I want to change it up a little bit. So now we have every page is inheriting these styles. So it's starting to look just a little bit better. So let's go ahead and add maybe a couple more styles here. Let's give paragraphs a background color. And let's make our paragraphs color white. Yeah. That's feeling nice. I'm going to go ahead and take P out of this because I don't want to target my P's anymore. And so now we want to add just a little bit of padding to it. See how this is like completely cramped? We want that paragraph to have a little bit more padding. So that's called padding. And here you get to define, let's say 5 pixels. So now you've noticed it put 5 pixel padding on all sides. Let's make it a little bit more. 10 pixel padding. There we go. And say you just want it to be on the top and the bottom, what you can actually do is if you do one value, it gets applied to all sides. If you do two values, then it goes top, bottom, left, right. So now if I say 10 pixels, 0 pixels, top, bottom have 10, left, right have none. Well, the right goes all the way because it's filling out the page. That's something we can address later. If you do 4 values, then you're doing one for each side. So I'm going, it goes like this. If I go 1 value, then it does all. If I do 2, then it's going top, bottom, left, right. If I do 4, then it kind of goes around clockwise, just like a clock. Starts at the top. Top, right, bottom, left. So I can actually add 4 things here. I can go 10 pixels, 10 pixels, 0 pixels on the bottom, and 0 pixels on the left. So now I have padding here, which you can't quite see because once my text gets over there, you'd be able to see it. And then I got some there. For now, we're just going to go with 10 pixels on all sides and call it a day. So now any paragraph I add on any of my pages is going to get a gray background, white text, and a nice little padding there. Here, let's experiment just to find out. Yep, there's some more page 2 content. It's nice. Everything I get throughout my entire site, every paragraph is going to have a lovely little look. Let's say my H2, I'm going to leave that right where it is. So this is kind of basically how we're going to style some things. Let's say we want just this one paragraph to have a different color to it. What do we do then? We want to give it what's considered a class. Yes, I know we're not supposed to have upper and lower class and the classes are bad, but in this case, it's just what we're going to call it. Class secondary. Let's do that. Class secondary. Right now, nothing changed. But now I can add a rule targeting class of secondary, and I'm going to add a dot. The dot means I'm looking for a class. So anything I put in here will now override what I put in there. I'm going to go background none, and this color is going to be, let's make this a little bit of a more grayed out color. Let's see if that happens. 555. There we go. Let's actually make it even more grayed out. 777. There we go. So now we have any paragraph gets this, and anything with a class secondary gets that. And because we specified a class is now more specific. If you'll notice, even if I put secondary before, usually what happens, by the way, with CSS rules is what comes after is going to override it. So if I add another P rule here, and this background is red, now this is overriding this because it happened after. That's why it's called cascading style sheets. It kind of cascades. It can get defined up here, but you can override it as you move on. So what we've done, though, is you'll notice class does not get overridden because class is considered more specific. It's an issue of specificity. So now secondaries get no background and they get a color of 777. Another way that you can target things, oh yes, and a nice thing about classes is it can apply to multiple things. It can apply to this. I can also make this paragraph have a class secondary as well. So now they both have secondary. I can also make this li right here have a class secondary, and it gets grayed out as well. It applies to anything that you add the class to. Another way that you can make a very specific issue in targeting is by ID. ID equals special. The difference between ID and class is you can only have one ID per page. So I can only have one thing that's called special on the page. I cannot create two things with an ID of special. You're breaking the rules. So I can say secondary has that. I'm gonna copy and paste here. And now there's something with an ID of special. And this background will be red because, after all, it's special. And now there you go. So each page can have one thing called special. But they can have as many things called secondary as they want. Usually, you know, you'll want to class things more than you want to ID things. ID is only something very specific, and you know for sure there's only going to be one. A common occurrence of that is ID equals navigation. There's usually only one primary navigation on the page. So in this case, I could make my UL have an ID of nav. And that's the kind of thing that you'll usually use an ID for. IDs are a little bit faster, as far as if you have 1,000 rules, IDs are going to be a little bit faster for your web page to appear. But classes are going to be a little bit slower. You usually really are not going to notice, though, unless you get tons and tons and tons and tons and tons of CSS classes. So here's kind of how we basically style out a web page. And in our next video, we're going to cover some more advanced CSS rules.